Already we have completed the lesson chemistry in everyday life, isn't it? And I have given you the worksheets also. Hope you would have done the worksheets. And we will have the worksheet discussion on Saturday. Okay, Saturday. By then you try to complete all your questions which has been asked in the worksheets. So then we can have a discussion. How to write the answer, what are the key terms and all those things we will discuss. And if you have completed, then only it will be helpful. If I am going to tell the answers, you can check. You yourself can correct. If any of the points left out, then that can be added. Okay, examples also. So we will have that on Saturday. Okay, get ready with your completed worksheet of chemistry in everyday life. Now we will start with a new lesson, that is chemistry in everyday, coordination chemistry. So this coordination chemistry is one of the phenomenal branch in inorganic chemistry. It's the biggest branch. Coordination chemistry is the biggest branch in the inorganic chemistry. So most of the compounds in the form of medicine, in the form of industrial use, in the form of food, okay, in the form of a catalyst, in the extraction procedures, we will be using the coordination compounds. Say for example, the chlorophyll. What is a chlorophyll? It is a pigment which is present in the green plant. So this chlorophyll is nothing but, it is a coordination compound. The hemoglobin in the blood, it is a coordination derivative, it is a complex. So hemoglobin. Then the vitamin derivatives, we have lots of vitamin. Vitamin B12, they are given you in the book, that is cyanocobalamin. It is the coordination derivative. So coordination compounds plays a significant role in the pharmaceutical industry. No medicine has been discovered without the complex, without the coordination. Without the coordination compound, no medicine has been established. Can you understand what I'm telling? So it plays a tremendous role in the pharmaceutical industry, in the medicine industry, for the manufacturing of various drugs. This coordination compounds plays a significant role. And today it is a little difficult chapter to understand. And what you have to do, you have to listen to me, what I am telling you, carefully. When you listen carefully, step by step, then it will be helpful for you to prepare well for the examination, and you can come to know about this coordination compounds, and it will become easier also. Now we will start with the ABs. One of the chapters that we are going to see, we will start now. The first thing is, what are called as coordination compounds. So from this chapter also you will be getting 1-3 mark, 1-2 mark. Similarly, you may get assertion reason type questions for 3 or otherwise 3-1 marks. So there is a chance. Understand? And most of the questions you may expect in neat examination from the coordination compounds. Coordination compounds plays a major weightage in the competitive examinations. So for both the coordination compounds we have to see today. And the second one is, we have to study about the difference between the double salt and coordination compounds or otherwise complex compounds. Okay, then third point which we are going to see is Wernes theory of coordination compounds. And the fourth one is nomenclature. Fourth one which we have to study is nomenclature is very, very important. Nomenclature is very, very important. Nomenclature. Okay, naming of coordination compounds. Definite proposition will be asked from the nomenclature. It is outer term. So either in 3 marks or otherwise in 1 mark, definite without the nomenclature, no question paper has come so far, and it is not going to come in the future also. So it's a compulsory question is the nomenclature and calculation of oscillation state. That also we will see in detail. Now first, we'll start with coordination compounds. So now, in a simple way of writing, listen carefully, the coordination compounds. This coordination compounds comprising of one is complex ion. Okay, the other one is complex ions. The other one is called as about outer ions, we will see when we are studying the nomenclature. Okay, that is what we are calling it as counter ions, that is cations or anions. Now coming to the complex ions. So complex ions consist of central metal atom, or an ion. Okay, this central metal atom or ion are nothing but transition metals. What are transition metals? The metals which are present in the D block series, D block group. They are called as the transition metals. So this transition metals has a tendency of forming the complex ions. That why these transition metals has a tendency of forming the complexes because of its variable oxidation state. Transition metals exhibits variable oxidation state. So that is why it has a tendency of forming the complex. Okay, now this coordination, complex, everything is same only. Now this complex consists of complex ions will be consisting of second one is the ligands. Second one, what we are calling as the ligands. Okay, these ligands are either made up of negative ions or otherwise neutral molecules. Or otherwise, we are calling it as neutral molecules. Or otherwise, this is called as neutral molecules. These transition metals are called as the Lewis acid. Whereas these ligands are called as the Lewis base. Now see, what is this Lewis acid? Lewis acid or electron pair acceptor. Whereas Lewis base or electron pair donor. Okay, and one more point in case of ligands. Will have at least one lone pair of electrons. Say for example, you take amine. So nitrogen will be having this lone pair of electrons. You take this water, again lone pair of oxygen. In the water, this oxygen atom has the lone pair of electrons. In amine, this nitrogen atom has the lone pair of electrons. It is the electron pair donor. It is an electron pair acceptor. So this central metal atom and the ligands will get combined together, giving rise to the formation of the complex ions. Made up of electron pair donor. coordinate overlap bond. It results in the formation of DCP. So coordination covalent bond. What is that? Coordinate covalent bond giving rise to the formation of coordination compounds. Forming what? Coordination compounds. So now define ligands. If they have asked in the examination what you will write, ligands, na? These points are the ligands. We will have at least one lone pair of electrons. Ligands or either active ions or otherwise neutral molecules. The ligands of the Lewis space. It has a tendency of donating the electron pair to the central metal atom. So definition for ligands. Ligands or the ion or otherwise a molecule. It is a negative ion or otherwise neutral molecule. Yeah, we cannot call it as an atom. It is an ion or otherwise a molecule which has a tendency of donating the electron pair to the central metal atom or an ion, giving rise to the formation of the complex. Giving rise to the formation of complex compound or giving rise to the formation of coordination compounds. They are called as the ligands. What are called as the central metal atom or the ion? The central metal atom or ion are nothing but the transition metals. These transition metals usually act as a Lewis acid. What is a Lewis acid? It has a tendency of accepting the electrons from the ligands, giving rise to the formation of the complex. So complex compounds are otherwise coordination compounds. So this is central metal atom. The other one is called as what? Ligands. Okay. Shall I give one example for central metal atom and the ligands? Say for example, you take CO, now NH3 6. I am writing a compound like this. So this is cobalt, which is the central metal atom on an ion. Cobalt is the central metal atom on an ion. This cobalt is as the boundary letter of amine, isn't it? This amine is called as the ligands. Is called as what? Ligands. And this is called as what? Central metal atom or ion. This is called as central metal atom or otherwise ion. That shall I write? I can write example. I can write it here. No? Example. So you can then understand. That is cobalt. NH3 6. Now what happens? See, this CO is the central metal atom. Central metal atom. And now this NH3, this is cobalt. And this NH3 is called as amine. See how many M I am giving? I am writing 2M. 2M represents what? Coordination compound letter for the amine. When you write only 1M amine, then it represents the functional derivative of organic compounds. So you must be very careful when you are writing ammonia or amine derivatives. You must be very, very careful when you are writing the compounds. Okay, now it is amine. NH3 is amine, the coordination compound. This amine is acting as a ligand. So now this amine, what has to do? It will be acting as a Lewis base. So therefore this amine has to donate the electron pair. How many electron pair it is going to donate? It is going to donate the 6 electron pairs. How many electron pairs? 6 electron pairs to the central metal atom or an ion. Therefore that 6 is called as the coordination number. Coordination called as coordination number. Can you understand what I mean? So coordination number. Then what we have, the central metal atom will have its oxidation state. So we have to go for calculating the oxidation number. See, the oxidation number of this cobalt will be 3+. I will tell you how I have written this 3+. Okay. So now you see, so cobalt, central metal atom is there, ligand is there, and the coordination number is there, and this is the oxidation number. This is called as what? Oxidation number. Labeling oxidation number. Okay, so central metal atom, ligand, coordination number, the oxidation number enclosed within the parenthesis. This is called as parenthesis. This is called as parenthesis. Parenthesis means square bracket. In chemistry, center metal atom, ligand, the number of electrode pairs being donated to the center metal atom, which we are calling it as a coordination number. Then we will be having the oxidation number. This oxidation number related to the center metal atom or an ion, and it is enclosed within the parenthesis, which we are calling it as an enthalpy, coordination enthalpy. We are calling it as what? Coordination enthalpy. So this much you have to write. What is meant by coordination compound? All these till this. The example and the labeling you have to write. Can you understand? Shall we mix again? So what are coordination compounds? The coordination compounds will be comprising of complex ions. The other one is called as counter ion. The complex ions will be consisting of central metal atom or an ion and the ligands. What are central metal atom ion or the ligands ions? Central metal atom or the ions are the transition metals. So in example, we ask you, why transition metals has a tendency of forming the complex ion? What is the reason? Because of its variable oxidation state. See, in case of cobalt, we cannot say only it will be having what? 3+. So it, depending upon the number of the ligands, number of the electron pair, the oxidation number of the cobalt will get varied. Either it can become 2+ or otherwise 4+. That depends. So depending on the number of the electron pair that is being donated by the ligands, or otherwise number of electron pair that is being accepted by the central metal atom, the oxidation number will get varied. So only the d block elements will be having what? The variable oxidation state, variable valency, variable oxidation state. Whereas if you take s block elements and the p block elements, they will exhibit what? Only the fixed oxidation state or otherwise a valency. Here in case of d block elements, it exhibits variable oxidation state. That is why these d block elements, the transition metals, has a tendency of forming complex. These d block elements has a tendency of forming the colored compounds, colored nature. It has a catalytic property, it has a magnetic property. Everything we are going to study in d block elements chapter also, similarly the coordination compounds also, they are also the coordination compound, because it is not for central metal atom or an ion, so obviously it should have the magnetic property. So the coordination compounds as a transition metal ion, so it will be a catalytic property, colored formation. So all those things the coordination compounds will also have. Why? Because the coordination compounds will be having what? The transition metal. Central metal atom or an ion will be the transition metal. This transition metals are called as the Lewis acid. Why we are calling this Lewis acid? Because it is an electron pair acceptor. Now coming to the ligands. Ligands will have at least one lone pair of electrons. At least it should have what? One lone pair of electrons. Then only it can give away what? The electron pair of the central metal atom or an ion. These ligands are always satisfied by the presence of negative ion or otherwise by the neutral molecule. These ligands are nothing but it is a Lewis base. So the Lewis base are nothing but electron pair donor. The Lewis base is another electron pair donor. Now the ligands donate the electron pair to the central metal atom or an ion. So as we said, it gets combined, it gets coordinated, giving rise to the formation of the complex ion or a molecule or the coordination compounds. Complex ions are the basic molecules which we call it as coordination compounds. So example I have written here, that is CO(NH3)6, and within the outside the parenthesis I have written 3+. What is this CO? CO is nothing but central metal atom or an ion. This is a cobalt, this is a central metal atom or an ion, which accepts the electron pair from the ligands, that is NH3. So NH3 is getting coordinated. See, whenever the ligand is getting attached to the central metal atom or an ion, there will be some spatial arrangement. It exhibits geometry. That is why in this chapter also we will be studying about the isomerism. So there will be what? The geometry or otherwise spatial arrangement. That is, if there is a spatial arrangement, see, the central metal of the ligand attached to the central metal atom or an ion or bound to the central metal atom or an ion with certain spatial arrangement. With a spatial arrangement, which we are calling it as polyhedron. Polyhedron. This also keep it in mind. While we are studying the isomerism, I will tell you this. Since it is an introduction, I have given you, I have written this. What is going to be polyhedron? So the shapes we are telling are tetrahedral, square, planar, octahedral shape. Isn't it? So what is a polyhedron? Polyhedron is a fixed geometry. A geometry based on the spatial arrangement of the ligands over the central metal atom or an ion. That is what is polyhedron. You keep this one in your mind when we are going for the isomerism in elaborate ligand study. Okay. Now, so the central metal atom or an ion is bound towards the ligands. So ligand is amine. For amine, what is the spelling? A-I-N-E. plus 0 will be is equal to plus 3. So that is why I have written plus 3 or 3 plus oxidation state. Oxidation number of the central matter atom or ion. So there are various examples I have given you, given in the textbook. So when you are going, giving into that, we can calculate the oxidation number. It will get prepared for you also. Okay, now the central metal atom ligand with the coordination number enclosed with the oxidation number enclosed within the parenthesis. Then we are calling it as a coordination entity. This is called as what? Coordination entity. So coordination entity will be having what? Central metal atom, ligand, coordination number, and the oxidation number. All together we are calling it as coordination entity. What is meant by polyhedron? Polyhedron means the ligand getting attached to the central metal atom or an ion with a spatial arrangement. With a fixed geometry, which we are going to study in the Werner's theory, in the fixed geometry, with a spatial arrangement, then such type of compounds, coordination compounds exhibiting the with the spatial arrangement and the geometrical pattern, we are calling it as a polyhedron. So polyhedron will give us the formation of the structure to the coordination compound. So coordination compound exhibit the structures also. So there we are calling it as polyhedron. So now we study about the first one, that is coordination compound. After coordination compounds, now what we have to study? Coordination compounds comprising of complex ions and the outer ions. These complex ions are made up of what? Central metal atom or ion. This central metal atom ion are otherwise called as a transition metals. Transition metals are present in the D block series in the periodic table. Now these transition metals are called as a Lewis acid. Why we are calling it as a Lewis acid? Because it donates the electron pair. Then its complex ion consisting of what? Apart from central metal atom, it has the ligands also. The ligands, at least it should have one lone pair of electrons. So water, H2O, so oxygen has one lone pair of electron. Amine, so nitrogen has one lone pair of electrons. So it is satisfied by what? Negative ions are otherwise a neutral molecule. Here I have taken amine. So amine is what? It is a neutral molecule. So the ligands will always be satisfied by the negative ion, which is an anion, or otherwise a neutral molecule. It is actually acting as a Lewis base. Lewis base means what? It is an electron pair donor. So this amine is a ligand. So therefore this amine donates the electron pair. How many electron pairs? 6 electron pairs. 6 electron pairs is being donated to the central metal atom or ion. So our amine is an electron pair donor. It donates the electron pair to the central metal atom or ion. To the central metal atom or ion. So therefore this central metal atom or ion should act as what? Electron pair acceptor. It is an electron pair. The electron pair acceptors are called as a Lewis acid, electron pair donors are called as the Lewis base. Okay, then counter ions we have. The counter ions are either cations and anions. About the counter ions, when we go for the nomenclature, I will tell you what is this counter ions and how we have to identify and how we have to give the nomenclature. Now, the central metal atom or an ion combining with that of a ligands, giving rise to the formation of a complex ion molecule or otherwise coordination compounds, and examples I have given. So that is the coordination compounds. So the next one is double salts and complex compounds. Okay, you'll see that. So double salt, the difference. They've asked the question in the examination, double salt. The other one is complex compounds. The other one is called as complex. Double salt. Double is complex compounds. Okay, see, this double salt as well as complex compounds, both are called as addition compounds. Both are called as what? This double salt as well as the compound, the complex salts are called as an addition compounds. Why we are calling this addition compounds? Because the double salt also found due to the combination of two simple salts. Whereas the complex, now only we study the complex compounds. Complex compounds also formed due to the addition of central metal atom and the ligands. So double salt is a complex compound, addition compound. Complex compounds are also called as an addition compounds. So now double salts, when two simple salts are mixed together. In a fixed stoichiometric proportion, or otherwise, we can call it as equimolar proportion, equimolar mixed together in a fixed stoichiometric proportion or a neatly molar proportion, then we are calling it as a double sorption. Here, what is happening in case of complex compound sorption addition compounds? These addition compounds are formed due to the combination of the ligands with the central metal atom or ion, with the central metal atom or otherwise ion, the central metal atom or otherwise ions. Now, so this double salts exists only in the solid state. It exists only in the solid state. Now, this double salt I am taking, the double salt, I am mixing it with the water. When I am mixing it in the water at its aqueous state, the double salts will get split up into constituent ions. The double salts will get dissociate, or otherwise it gets splits up into constituent ions. Whereas this complex compounds can be mixed with water or otherwise with a suitable solvent. Though it is mixed with that of a water or a suitable solvent, it will not get dissociate. It will not get dissociate to form constituent ions. We'll go for an example. Double solid is an example. So double solid, next point, for double solid example, let me go for an example. First one is carbonylite salt. What is the formula of carbonylite salt? Potassium chloride mixed with that of magnesium chloride with 6 molecules of water. This is called as carbonylite salt. Next one is, we have Mohs salt. Next one is what? Mohs salt. What is the formula of Mohs salt? This is carbonylite salt and this is called as Mohs salt. What is the formula of Mohs salt? FeSO4 into diammonium sulfate, diammonium sulfate into 6 molecules of water. We are calling it as water, Mohs salt. Next example is potash alum. So what is the formula of potash alum? So potash alum formula, K2SO4 into Al2SO4 thrice into 24 molecules of water. This is called as what? We are calling it as potash alum. So these are the examples for what? Examples for the double salt. So carbonylite salt, potassium chloride, magnesium chloride into 6 molecules of water, Mohs salt, ferrous sulfate into diammonium sulfate into 6 molecules of water. Potash alum is potassium sulfate into aluminium trisulfate into 24 molecules of water. Now I am mixing it with the water. Or otherwise a solvent mixture. So what will happen now? It gets dissociates. How it gets splits up into constituent ions? This becomes K plus. Plus 2 plus 1, 3 Cl, oxidation state is minus. Plus magnesium has got an oxidation state, 2 plus, plus 6 molecules of water. This is called as splitting into its constituent ions. Now, this ferrous sulfate, diammonium sulfate into 6 molecules of water will also get dissociate. How it will get dissociate, you see? Fe 2 plus plus SO4 2 minus. How many SO4s are there? 2 SO4s are there. Plus 2 NH4 minus plus 6 molecules of water. Like this, it will get dissociates. Next, what we have is potash alum. Potash alum will also get dissociated. How it will get dissociated? This gets dissociated to 2K plus plus sulfate is, how many sulfates are there? 4 SO4 2 minus plus 3 plus oxidation state, isn't it? Now, when it is getting mixed with that of water, it will not get split up into CO3 plus NH3 plus like that. It will not get dissociate. It will not dissociate, into ions. That is the difference. It will not get dissociate into ions. Okay. Now we will see from the first the double salts and the complex salt. Complex. So double salt. We do. Simple salts are mixed together. Both are called as what? Addition compounds. Why we are calling this addition compounds? In case of a double salt, two simple salts are mixed together, giving rise to the formation of addition compound. What is going to be complex salt? Complex salt, complex is also considered to be an addition compound because it is formed due to the combination of what? Several metal atoms plus that of the ligand. Isn't it? Several metal atoms present. Similarly, ligand is also present. So therefore, we are calling it as complex. Here, double salt. Why we are calling it as double salt? Because it is a combination of two simple salts. The two simple salts are mixed together in a fixed equimolar proportion or otherwise stoichiometric proportion, then we are calling it as the double salt. The double salt will always exist in the solid state. And when this double salt is mixed with the water, then it will get split up into its constituent ions. Now coming to this complex compounds when it is mixed, it will get mixed with the water or otherwise with a suitable solvent. Though it is getting mixed, it will not get dissociated into constituent ions. So example for the double salts are scorpion salts, more salts, gypsum, we have lots of examples. So I have written only three: carbonate salt, more salt, and potassium ion. Carbonate salt formalized potassium chloride into magnesium chloride into 6 molecules of water. More salt is ferrous sulfate into diamine sulfate into 6 molecules of water. Potassium ion is potassium sulfate into aluminium sulfate into 24 molecules of water. When these double salts are getting mixed with the water, then it will get split up into its constituent ions like K plus, plus 3Cl minus, plus Mg2 plus, plus 6 molecules of water. More salts also will get split up into its constituent ions. Potassium ion also will get dissociated into its constituent ions. Whereas in case of complex compounds, it will not get dissociated into its constituent ions. These are called as the complex compounds and this is called as the double salts. Okay, hope you can understand what is a double salt and what is a complex compound. The difference between double salts and the complex compounds. Okay, now third topic is Werner's theory. Alfred Werner in the year 1930 proposed the Werner's theory. The Werner's laid much emphasis on the coordination of compounds, properties as well as the structure. So his postulates, his discoveries, everything is based on the properties and the structure, geometrical pattern of the coordination compounds. He laid emphasis on the structure and the geometrical pattern of the coordination compounds. So Alfred Werner in the year 1913, he formulated the Werner's theory of coordination compounds. The Werner's theory of the coordination compounds laid emphasis on the properties and the structure of the coordination compounds. Okay, now we will see the Werner's theory. Secondary valence means again linkage. Now this primary valence corresponds to the oxidation number of central metal atom, whereas the secondary valence corresponds to the coordination number of the coordination number of the ligands. Coordination number of ligands. Okay. So oxidation number of central metal atom or ion and coordination number of ligands. So secondary valence corresponds to the coordination number of ligands and primary valence corresponds to the oxidation number of central metal atom or the ion. Now this will go for the difference now. What is the difference? Primary valence. Second one is called as what? Secondary valence. Primary valence and secondary valence. Now this primary valence corresponds to the oxidation number of central metal atom which is satisfied by negative ion. If I write an example, you can better understand. Satisfied by negative ion, which is satisfied by the negative ion. Whereas this secondary valence corresponds to the coordination number of the ligands which is satisfied by, which is satisfied by negative ions or otherwise neutral molecules. Negative ions or otherwise the neutral molecules. Negative ions or otherwise we are calling as neutral molecules. Negative ions or otherwise neutral molecules. This is for the primary valence. Second one, this satisfied this primary valence. This primary valence is ionizable in nature. It is ionizable. Since it is ionizable, it is non-directional in nature. It is non-directional in nature. Whereas, which is satisfied by the secondary valence is satisfied by negative ions of the neutral molecules, which is non-ionizable. Which is non-ionizable. Non-ionizable. Therefore, it is directional in nature. It is directional in nature. Since it is directional in nature, it exhibits spatial arrangement. It exhibits spatial arrangement. The spatial arrangement leads to the formation of geometry. So the spatial arrangement gives rise to the formation of what? Giving rise to the formation of geometry. So geometry. Okay. Now for example, you take CO, Cl3 into 6 molecules of NH3. Now, this CO is central metal atom. CO is covalent central metal atom which is bonded to 6 NH3 group. 6 NH3. So, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 NH3, isn't it? NH3. So N should be getting attached because N will be having what? The lone pair of electrons. So NH3. NH3. Similarly, NH3. NH3. Similarly, N. H3. NH. Correct. Now, next one is Cl3. So Cl3 I am representing like this. 1 Cl, the other Cl, and one more Cl. Anyway, I can write. Okay, one more Cl. So in this, what you can understand, I have given the bond like this, isn't it? The full stretched line. The other one is a dotted line. This full-fledged line represents, the full-fledged line represents, the full-fledged line hydrogen, no? That represents, that corresponds to the non-ionizable valence. The dotted line represents ionizable valence. Ionizable valence. So non-ionizable valence is responsible. responsible for giving rise to the formation of fixed geometry. Responsible for giving rise to the formation of fixed geometry. So therefore, now how I can write CO NH 3 6 times into Cl3. What is this Cl3? This Cl3 is called as the ionizable valence. This ionizable valence plus 1 NH3, this 6 NH3 is there. That together it's a complex, isn't it? This complex is considered to be 1 and this Cl3 will be considered as 4. So totally, how many ions are present? Totally, how many ions are present? 1 plus 3, 4 ions. So this ionizable valence will be placed outside the parenthesis. Now this is called as counter ions. This is called as what? We are calling it as counter ion. This is called as counter ion. And this is called as ligand and this is called as the central metal atomic ion. So this Cl3 corresponds to the oxidation state of the central metal atomic ion. Now this Cl3 is satisfied by negative ion. So chlorine is a negative ion, isn't it? That is Cl minus. So chlorine is a negative ion, satisfied by the negative ion. So this is an example, the Werner's theory of example, Werner's representation. So Werner's representation. So we have to place it inside the parenthesis, the square bracket. So now we will study Werner's theory. So Werner's theory, Alfred Werner in the year 1913, he proposed the Werner's theory. So Werner, Alfred Werner, laid emphasis on finding out the properties and the structure. Structure means geometry, isomerism, polyhedron of the coordination compound. So Werner's theory is based on what? Structure. He gave much importance to the structure and the properties of the coordination compound. He is the first who proposed the year 1913 to Werner's theory. He is considered to be the founder of coordination compounds. Now, the Werner's theory is based on two concepts. One is primary valence, the other one we are calling the secondary valence. What is primary valence? Valence means what? Valence means ligand. It's not valency. Valence. Valence means ligand. Here, secondary valence is ligand. The primary valence represents the oxidation number of central metal atom or ion, whereas the secondary valency represents the coordination number of the ligands. So, what is the primary valence? Primary valence corresponds to the oxidation number, corresponds to this oxidation number. This is 3 plus, isn't it? So, oxidation number is what? This is 3 plus. So, oxidation number of the central metal atom or ion. So, this one corresponds to the central metal atom or ion. This coordination number corresponds to the ligands. Corresponds to the ligands. So, the coordination number of the ligands. It is called the secondary valence. Now, we take primary valence. This primary valence always satisfied by negative ion. The primary valence always satisfied by negative ion. What is the negative ion here? Cl minus. So always satisfied by the negative ion. And it is an ionizable ion. It is called as what? Ionizable ion. And it is non-directional in nature. Then secondary valence is satisfied by negative ion or otherwise a neutral molecule, which is non-ionizable. Since it is non-ionizable, it is directional. So directional. Directional is represented by a bold line, isn't it? So which is directional in nature. So since it is directional in nature, it exhibits spatial arrangement. The spatial arrangement leads to the formation of the geometry. Example I have written here. So COCl3 into 6 molecules of NH3. So if you have dotted line I have written, dotted line represents what? This dotted line represents the ionizable valency and the bold line represents the non-ionizable valence. Okay, so this is the representation of Werner's theory. So I have completed Werner's theory also. So what are the things that we have studied from the first? Today we are studying about the coordination compounds. So under the coordination compounds, first we studied what is a coordination compound. So coordination compound is a complex ion and it has got counter ion. The complex ion is made up of central metal atom and the ligands. What is the central metal? First two nodes which are given, you take central metal atom or the ion, the other one is a ligand. What is central metal atom or an ion? It is made up of transition metals. Second one, what we have to take, we have to call it as the Lewis. We have to call it as a Lewis acid. Why we have to call it as a Lewis acid? Because it is an electron pair acceptor, isn't it? Now, coming to ligands. What are the ligands? Ligands are the Lewis base. Why it is a Lewis base? Because it is an electron pair donor. It donates a pair of electrons. Then, this ligand should always have at least one lone pair of electrons. These ligands will be satisfied by either the negative ions or the neutral molecules. Now, what is this ligand? Ligand has a tendency of donating the electron pair to the central metal atom or ions. Then we are calling this a ligand. The other side we have counter ions. What is a counter ion? Counter ion is nothing but either it may be a cation or otherwise anionic species. That in detail we are going to study when we are going to learn about the nomenclature, isn't it? Next, what we have studied? We studied about the coordination enthalpy. What is the coordination number? What is the oxidation number? What is membrane parenthesis? What is membrane polyhedron? All those things we have studied. What is the coordination number? Coordination number will be written as a subscript below the ligands. What is the coordination number? Coordination number is actually the electron pair that is being donated to the central metal atom or otherwise to the ion. So that gives rise to the formation of coordinate covalent linkage or coordinate covalent bond. Then next one is oxidation number. The oxidation number corresponds to the central metal atom or an ion. What is the oxidation number? The original oxidation state is central metal atom or an ion. So with the original state, we have to subtract with that of the coordination number. Then we will be getting a charge. We will be getting a value. That charge or the value is called as the oxidation number, which corresponds to the central metal atom or an ion. Okay. Then what is membrane coordination enthalpy? Coordination enthalpy will be having the ligands, central metal atom, coordination number, and the oxidation number. All together will be giving rise to the formation of coordination enthalpy. What is membrane polyhedron? Polyhedron means it is a geometry. Geometry of the coordination compound. The central metal atom will be getting surrounded by the ligands. The ligands will exhibit orientation, the spatial arrangement around the central metal atom or an ion, giving rise to the formation of different shapes or a different geometry like trigonal, bipyramidal, tetrahedral, square pair or octahedral shapes. So those things we are calling it as polyhedron. Now, coordination compounds exhibit different geometry, different shapes. So we are going to study about isomerism. So therefore it is called as a polyhedron. Second topic, what we have studied about the simple double salts and the coordinated complex compounds or the difference. What is a double salt? When both the double salt as well as the coordination salts both are considered to be an addition compound. So why is an addition compound? Double salt is an addition compound because when the double salts are getting formed, when two simple salts are mixed together in a fixed geometrical ratio or in an equipolar proportion, then we call it as a double salt. What is a double salt? Double salt is when two simple salts are mixed together in a fixed proportion, equimolar proportion or otherwise a stoichiometric proportion, then we are calling it as a double salt. So this double salt, when it is dissolved in a water, in its aqueous state, it will get dissociated into its constituent ions. So we have various examples, formalite salts we have, then we have potash alum, then we have more salt. What is the formula of formalite salt? KCl into MgCl2 into 6 molecules of water. When it is being dissociated, when it is dissolved in water, it gets dissociated into its constituent ion, that is K plus, plus 3Cl minus, plus Mg2 plus, plus 6 molecules of water. Similarly, we have to write for potash alum. Similarly, we have to write for more salt. Whereas in case of the complex compounds, the complex compounds will be having central metal atom and the ligand. Both are combined together, giving rise to the formation of the complex compounds. So the complex compounds, when it is dissolved in the water, it will get dissolved. It can be mixed with the water or otherwise with a suitable solvent. Though it is getting mixed, it will not get dissociated into its constituent ions. So such type of compounds are called as a complex compounds. If it will get dissociated into its constituent ions, then we are calling it as a double salt. So second topic. Third topic, what we have studied is a Werner's theory. The Werner's theory also I have given you in detail. Okay, the Werner's theory and its postulates I have given about the Werner's theory. Werner's theory explains about the structure and the properties of coordination compounds. Alfred Werner formulated the Werner's theory in the year 1930. So Werner's theory will be having primary valence. The other one is called as what? Secondary valence. The primary valence will be correspond to the oxidation